Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to my channel. Today, in this video, we are going to learn a class 10 English poem, Sonnet 73, That Time of the Year's Question and Answers. And this is part 2 of the question and answer session. Part 1 of the session has already been uploaded in the channel. And also, the explanation of this poem has been uploaded. And the link of the same will be shared in the descriptions for your convenience. So let's start with this. But before that, students, if you are watching my video for the first time, do subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon so that you get the notifications of all the upcoming videos. Do watch the video till end, and if you like it, hit the like button and do not forget to share with your friends. So let's start with the question answers. We had to start up with B, close study. Read the following lines of the poem carefully, discuss in pairs, and then write the answers to the questions given below them. Under that first question, bare ruined choirs were late the sweet birds sang. So under that A question, bare ruined choirs refers to a crumbling church, trees empty of birds, or both? The answer is both. It refers to both crumbling church and empty trees without birds. Okay, so it's both. Next, why has the sound disappeared? Answer, through a change of season, autumn season has set in and brought cold winds. Hence, birds have flown away to warmer climates. C question. Why has the poet used the word late? Answer, the poet used the word late because the birds were singing on the branches recently, but not now. Next, fourth question. Why are the branches of trees leafless? Answer, because it is autumn season, there is no leaves in the trees. Thus, the branches of the trees are leafless. So, moving on to the next question. Again, we have a sentence and then three sub-questions under that. Question is, this thou perceivest, which makes thy love most strong, to love that well which thou must leave ere long. So, your first sub-question is, who is thou here? Thou is referred to a friend or a beloved, whom the poet is asking to love him better because they will have to part soon. Question B. What makes love more strong? Answer. The changes and sign of death will make love more strong. C question. Explain the literal meaning of the last line. Answer. The poet feels that he might have to leave soon as he is in the autumn season at twilight in the form of embers, and so he feels the pull of love now more than ever. Okay, so moving on to the next main, that is paragraph writing, wherein you have to jot down the important points and then you have to develop those into paragraph. So here directly I have written the paragraph as an answer. So let's see that. First question, how is the couplet a fitting conclusion to the three quatrains? Answer, the first two stanzas establish what the poet perceives the young man now sees as he looks at the poet. Those yellow leaves and bare boughs and the faint afterglow of the fading sun. The third stanza reveals that the poet is speaking not of his impending physical death, but the death of his youth, and subsequently his youthful desires, those very things which sustained his relationship with the young man. These 12 lines of the sonnet have a depressing and inevitable tone to them, leaving the reader with a sense of fatalism, and are starkly contrasted by the last two lines, which suggest that we ought to live the life we have to the fullest. Okay, moving on to the second question. Bare ruined choirs where late sweet birds sang has double images. Explain what the poet wants his friend to behold. Answer. During the summer and summer season, sorry, during the spring and summer season, the birds make their nests on the crushed green trees full of leaves. They sit on the branches and sing sweetly. These songs of the birds are similar to the choirs in the church. As winter approaches, the trees start shedding their leaves and the birds fly away to warm places. The birds have abandoned the trees, similar to the choir of a ruined church. The poet wants his friend to visualize these images and compare them with his approaching old age, which is compared to the bare trees and the ruined church. Okay. So here, students, we come to an end with the question and answers of Sonnet 73, that time of the year poem. I hope this question answers were informative and helpful for you all. If you like the video, do hit the like button and share with your friends. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel too, so that you get the notifications of all the upcoming videos. So we'll be back soon with more such videos. Till then, stay safe and take care. Thank you.